forgot to mention some of the things that I've done in preparation for the puppy's arrival. We have some box lock hemostats. This is what I use to clamp the umbilical cord. And so I put one about an inch and a half away from the umbilical cord, the tummy of the pup. And then I leave a space and I clamp near the placenta. And that kind of, I leave this one hanging from mom. And this one stays on the puppy. And I don't have a cameraman or another person here with me today, so it's going to be difficult for me to film and care for Ella. So unfortunately, I won't be able to catch it on video. However, this kind of stays hanging on mom. And so if the placenta is retained, I can tend to this later. I can always just tug on it and prevent a retained placenta, which can cause some serious problems. I do have a catheter and some lube. Some people use mineral oil, some people will use a silicone-based lubrication, some people will use a water base. I choose silicone. It's safe for humans and safe for puppies and mamas. So I just make sure she's well lubed before she goes into labor. That's just a little trick I like to do myself. And, Ella, that's a big push. She's over here now. She's decided to get a little closer to Mama here. Hey, honey? Yeah. I have a little, what do you call these, aspiration bulbs? So what you do is you squeeze it, take all the air out, put it in the puppy's mouth, and suck up the mucus. Make sure the passages are clear, and just a little scissor to snip between the hemostats, the umbilical cord. I don't let Ella eat the placenta because she just pukes it up, and it doesn't seem to sit well with her. I do have a few things that kind of help things along. One is called Breeder's Edge Nurture Mate, and this is like a colostrum supplement. Said to help the pups, and mum's in active labor, it just kind of gives them a boost. Some people use NutriCal, some people use Polycos. Anyway, that's what I like. Instead of CalSorb, I like to use Breeder's Edge OroCal Plus. This stuff isn't available in Canada, so I have to order it from the States. CalSorb, I find that Ella vomits a lot with. And I never know how much calcium she's actually taken. Calcium kind of helps contractions. And it just helps make sure mom has what she needs during her whelping. Anyway, I'll probably give her some of this very soon. And I'll make another little clip soon. Just help her out a little bit here. There goes another contraction. Hey, Ella girl. Hey. How's it going? Say, Mom, this isn't fun. Gonna have some puppies soon? Sweet face? Some puppies soon? Yeah. She loves to lean up against me, and I have a heating pad in the whelping box on low with a couple of layers of whelping padding on top to prevent overheating for the pups. Over there by the fireplace, which is not on right now because bitches prefer to whelp in the cooler temperatures, so once the pups arrive, I will put the fireplace on low, but I have a digital scale there, and in the far corner, that's my old scale, in the far corner is a little bassinet that I made. Underneath that pink pad padding is just one of those magic beanie things that you heat up in the microwave with lots of padding on top. So I've got that set up about an hour ago. So I have a nice, clean, safe, warm place to take puppy's first pictures. Mika's over here in the corner. Mika! Mika, hello! Hi! Can you look over here? Meeks! Mika! Say hi! Oops. There's Mika. She's never too far away. She made sure she groomed Ella. That's Mika's mommy. And she's never too far away from Ella when she's whelping. I know some breeders like to keep their bitches separate. Some bitches are really aggressive or may steal or want to kill puppies. I've heard some crazy stories. These girls are very, very sweet. No, they're still animals, but I don't leave them alone. They're very, very sweet puppies. And here's Ella, and there's Mika. So another update soon.